in 3, 4, and land. With the pointy things and colours jet on the back of them. And we'll have a fantastic display of various different aerobatics, some wonderful aircraft, warblers, Catalina. Shakes for you later in the morning. Crews are getting the balloons prepared at this moment in time, and we'll keep you updated with any of the balloons that are actually going to be appearing, and anything that's interesting in terms of historical interest, and also because of the things it's done.
see in the background. Pilots tend to be a lot smaller. So here comes Tim, who's one of our display pilots. He's exiting the control site. There's a nice sight, watching the Grob flying off behind the balloons. Very elegant aircraft, a powered glider effectively. And you'll see the twin Grobs coming back later on this afternoon for part of the...
survey map. Ordnance survey mapping, of course, is the UK.
This is a huge aeroplane and a relatively small field, but this is what it was designed to actually do. So get your cameras out. Now this was the dropship for the Red Devils over the last 2 days. Beautifully done. Absolutely. That is a 10 out of 10 landing.
How many times? As long as the airframe is fine, you're controlled by the engine. And also the gearboxes. Anything that's dynamic has a life. The airframe itself is fine.
But it's not like cars.
Cars. Fixed-wingers, like the airline, there's pressurisation. They have, they're limited on pressurisation.
Fixed or retractable undercarriage, and a variety of different power plants from about 85 horsepower to 95 horsepower. One of the most common used is the 85 horsepower Jabiru engine. The aircraft is flown today by Tim Jones. Part of a stable of aircraft that he operates, including the Grom.
Yeah. 778 Squadron Royal Navy Fleet Air Rub. The first into operations was number 807 Squadron. Again in box formation.
lead to Wingman. Wing guy in the number four slot position.
Down to the sea.
if you ever get the opportunity to see Aero Pyrotechnics, certainly head that way. There goes Bob. Bob Grimstead, he's heading off to his home base now. Again, another wonderful display in another era. Flown by Martin Carrington and I believe David Burrell. This harkens back to the days of the Barnstormers. That magnificent era of flying post-World War I, where surplus aircraft were plentiful and pilots were plentiful too, and many of those guys wanted to continue. You can see them waving there. It wasn't until 1938 that the authorities in America actually
could going up,
but that bunting manoeuvre, you can have that on your own.
Is now open. Following on from him, we have the rest of the team, with Snoke trailing behind. Hutchinson, come in for a high performance landing. You'll deliberately turn the canopy and accelerate it towards the ground for the last safe moment to recover and land. So big round of applause for Lance Corporal Lee Hutchinson.
I missed that. Couldn't keep up.
Next is the Red Devils Jump Master, Corporal Weiss. Give a bigger round of applause. The rest of the team will now follow the Jump Master's landing pattern. He's the most experienced member of the team. Next we have Corporal Stephen Handley, ladies and gentlemen. Followed by Corporal Henry Bull. See two canopies linked together by a flag. The last safe moment, they'll release the flag and split for landing.